Hello everybody, I'm Gabi and this is Gabi Tech. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, don't forget to like and subscribe and also to enroll for my special Divom D2 giveaway. Divom D2 is a Bluetooth speaker that seems like mini retro computer and you really want to have. So enroll for the giveaway by going to the Divom D2 review and you will find how to do it there. In today's video, we're gonna take a look at one very beautiful computer case. One of my favorite brands, Be Quiet. It's white and I am so addicted to white color, especially for computer parts. This case is pure beauty. It's very versatile and very quiet because it's Be Quiet, yes. So we'll do a little bit rebuild in this case and we'll put some components there, you will see how it looks. And if you stay till the end of the video, I will tell you a very special story about poisonous mushrooms. So we managed to put the components into the beautiful Be Quiet Silent Base 802 computer case. I really like this case, it's very easy to work with it, very clean, very versatile, very quiet and nice case. The guy wanted to move his components from his Corsair 500D RGB case, which apparently don't have the best airflow that you can think of, and this one has a lot of airflow, especially with the versatility and the different parts that you can customize the way you want. I like the color, it's white, the material is sturdy, it has legs that are hidden in the box. I couldn't find them yesterday, it was actually funny that they wasn't easy to find. The components are far away from each other, they look good into this case. The other one was like too tiny for them. If you remember from one of my previous videos, this is the front of the case, one of the panels. It has a second panel that you can choose. This one is the mesh. It gives better airflow. And this one is the one that has a special pad that makes it silent, quiet, Be Quiet. You know, the Be Quiet cases, they have specialty these pads that are for the acoustics. Very nice case. You can always change this with that. The front part is very easy to remove. There's a dust filter. And we see two of the three Be Quiet pure wings that are coming along with the case. I like this mesh. It provides good airflow. We have also a dust filter on the bottom. You just slide in and you clean it. On top we see I/O section, we have audio jack, headphone jack, USB Type-C and the fan controller with 4 modes, auto, 1, 2 and 3, extremely convenient to control from here. And the on off button. Here again we have the opportunity to customize the case. We have it in 3 different ways. This one for the most optimal airflow into the case. Then we can use the mesh. If you don't want airflow and you want your computer to be super quiet. I like good airflow. My temperatures would be nice. The reason that the guy decided to change the computer case with this one was his temperatures not being optimal in the Corsair case. And here we have the push and pull setting that we managed to do with the fans here, here and here. The cables are hidden underneath the PCU shroud and here at the back of the computer case that is also very easy to remove with a special. This is the cable management I did. It looks optimal for my taste. I still took a lot of time. Here you can see the hard drives. You have an extra bracket for a hard drive. We have two and there is a third bracket here that comes into the set. Again, we have the acoustic pad here. It's thick, it's nice material. The build theme is black and white. Here you see these small plastic covers that are covering the cables from behind. Doing its job perfectly well. The components, we have the RTX 3080 Extreme Aorus Extreme Waterforce. We have the MSIX 570 Tomahawk Wi-Fi motherboard that I don't really like because the ports are not enough, at least for my taste. Then we have the Be Quiet AIO Pure Loop. 2 sticks ballistics, 32GB, Corsair power supply, underneath the PCU shroud. This case is clean job. We have the radiator shroud here for up to 420mm radiators, but the guy don't want it into the case. The front glass is also very easy to remove. Again with the same mechanism as the back one. You just press the button and you lift up. If you have to fix something, no more unnecessary unscrewing and screwing screws. Now I put some mudgy fingers on the glass that I need to clean with my special glass vac by Bosch or special glass cleaner that I bought especially for computer cases. And since you stayed till the end of the video, I'll remind you to subscribe to my channel and to like this video, and I'll tell you a special story about poisonous mushrooms. The most common poisonous mushroom in Bulgaria is called the dead cap or Amanthina phalloides. It looks a lot like an edible mushroom that you buy from the supermarket. But they say that it has some green coloration on the top. It's very toxic, it has toxins. One of them is amanitin, amanitin. And 5 grams of this mushroom can kill a 70 kg person. That means it's very poisonous. Especially when you eat soup or something like this from it, because the amanitin is a thermostable toxin. It doesn't get destroyed by the heat. When somebody who ate wild mushrooms comes with to the hospital, you need to ask him what kind of mushrooms did you eat. And when he says wild, you need to think immediately about the dead cap or Amanita phalloides when you're in Bulgaria, because that's the worst case. The more less poisonous mushrooms, you can get recovered by them, but this one, 90% of the time, the diagnosis is dead because the poisoning is very latent. First, when you eat the mushroom, up to 48 hours, there is no symptoms. Afterwards, the symptoms are coming in. Diarrhea, stomach pain, gastrointestinal symptoms. You get dehydrated, shock. The most dangerous thing about this amanitin toxin is that it attacks the hepatocytes, that's the cells of the liver. And it causes your liver to die. And basically, if you go out of this situation alive, you most likely will need a liver transplant. If you manage to survive up to 11 days after the first time you ate this mushroom, that means you may survive it. But it's very expensive. One day of treatment after mushroom poisoning costs around 2,500 euro per day. So only millionaires should eat poisonous mushrooms, because if you're a normal human, most likely your government wouldn't cover the cost about this treatment. There is no antidote for the mushroom poisoning with dead cap. You use different therapy with a lot of medications, corticosteroids, vitamins, heparin, and a lot of medications. There is also a complex, special complex that don't let your thrombocytes, that's the one of the blood cells, no matter. Anyway, that's too medical. But basically 2,500 euro a day in order for you to recover, and if you don't recover, which is a lot in the cases, nothing good happens to you. So be careful what kind of mushrooms are you eating. Don't eat wild mushrooms. Buy them from the store, it's more safe for you. Unless you know a person who works as a mushroom guy who goes around the woods to collect mushrooms for 20, 30 years. But even they do mistakes. In Bulgaria, there is a lot of cases of mushroom poisoning with dead cap. And the age doesn't matter in this case. No matter how young you are, mushroom can just destroy you. This dead cap, the amanitin toxin, can destroy you. And there is a specialty about these mushrooms. One of them can be less poisonous than the other, even though they are both dead caps. So basically, it's Russian roulette. Thank you very much for watching this video review. Be sure to like, subscribe, and follow me on social media.